9:18. You're listening to Business in Vancouver on Roundhouse Radio 98.3. I'm Romila Berryman.
And I'm Tyler Orton.
Well, last week we saw a lot of marijuana-related news come out. The Canadian Medical Cannabis Industry Association rebranded as Cannabis Canada to reflect the trade group's expanding mandate amid Ottawa's promise to legalize recreational pot. We also had the City of Vancouver issue its first license for a medical marijuana shop.
And also with us in studio is Kim Pickett. She's founder of KIMBO Design. And so what we're getting as we're seeing, you know, the medical marijuana industry is becoming more legitimized, especially here in Vancouver. And that kind of reflects, you know, efforts to perhaps rebrand certain organizations as well. Kim, you've been involved with helping dispensaries do this. Tell me a little bit about what you've been working with, talking to dispensaries about maybe efforts to rebrand, why that's important to you.
Well, I think it's important to everybody in the city. This topic, it's a very controversial, and with the storefronts being hidden, and it's coming off as a little bit shady. So I think that dispensaries and also the city has to be transparent with their storefronts, and for the stores, the dispensaries to look like hair salons.
Is this something you've seen with other dispensaries as well when you've worked with them? Because when we talk about rebranding, usually we're talking or we think about the changing face of a brand. But does it usually include re-strategization like this?
Yeah, so in terms of rebranding, we're not just talking about the image. We're talking about the narrative, the brand awareness. So all of those things, when you start your strategic plan, are involved. So for sure, it's not just the logo. It's everything. It's the voice, and it's what you're putting out to the public, and what kind of perception you want the public, and how they view you and see you.
Well, what kind of examples can you give us from the dispensaries that you've advised?
In terms of the dispensaries I've advised about what they're doing, I think that they're starting at their business plan first, and they're looking at getting the proper licenses in place before they even start the rebrand process.
Well, why is that so important, though? Because you bring it up before, you want to bring more of an air of credibility to some of these businesses. Tell me a little bit about what steps that you've been advising them to take going forward.
Well, I think the first step is getting their ducks in a row and getting a license first, because they're going to be investing a lot in terms of their business expenses. So before they get into the branding part of it, they should have all their licenses and follow regulations and that sort of thing.
That's Kim Pickett. She's the founder of KIMBO Designs with us in studio today to talk about marijuana related brands, including dispensaries. Now, Kim, it's interesting that you mention get your ducks in a row first, get a license, and then brand yourself.
And so then, Kim, this brings me back to you, because you're dealing with a lot of these dispensaries. Have they been receptive to a lot of the advice that you've been giving? Do they understand what you're trying to imbue upon them? Or is there, you know, maybe some a knocking of heads when it comes to, like, the image that you think would help them out versus the image that they may want themselves?
Mm-hmm. So I guess what I'm hearing is the regulations that are kind of vague, and there's a lot of gray area. I think that the dispensaries don't have the voice, and the voice is not out there. And I think that they have to be treated as, let's say, a hair salon, a business, because it is a business, and they have services and great services to offer the public, and that needs to be known. So, in terms of their brand, transparency and being able to advertise and market what they can offer is really important.
I think, Kim, we should bring up the fact that you are advising dispensary. Why haven't you brought any on to your design studio? Is there one factor that's missing in terms of you working with these dispensaries?
Well, I think it's also, it goes to the point of, there's such a gray area, and this industry is changing. And, in terms of, a business taking on, a branding investment, you know, there is a quite a significant investment that a business will have to do.
So it's just because the climate is shifting right now, and we don't know what the regulations look like, that you're not sure whether you want to take it on. Is that what you're...
Exactly. Well, it goes to them in terms of what they want to spend their money on, right? So a lot of the licenses are a big financial challenge for some of these dispensaries. So I think that they want to know that they're going to be around for the long term too, before they start putting money into marketing and advertising.
Well, that brings me to the next question, because you bring up the fact that it's a shifting climate right now. Mm-hmm. A year from now, we will be getting legislation introduced to Parliament. Mm-hmm. It's not going to get passed right away, though. There could be maybe up to another year of waiting behind this. Mm-hmm. We're looking at maybe 2 years down the road at the earliest, when we get to have maybe recreational pots legalized throughout all of Canada. Mm-hmm. How do you think this will impact just the way that it is seen as a legitimate industry? Do you think there's going to be this massive shift in the Canadian perspective? Are we already within that shift right now?
Well, I think it's going to definitely shift, for sure. And I kind of compare it to the alcohol industry, right? That, you know, when alcohol was not allowed, there was a lot of booze cans and that sort of thing. And then suddenly it was allowed and you're able to sell it. And, you know, it became a big, big industry, especially for the advertising industry too, right? So I think there's going to be quite a shift, and we're going to see some exciting things.
You're listening to Business in Vancouver on Roundhouse Radio 98.3. I'm Romila Berryman.
And I'm Tyler Orton.